All right, so now that we have a sense of what tit for tat does against various strategies, let's try to think about what we should do against tit for tat. So what do we do if we're facing tit for tat? So I'm just going to break it down to two possibilities. It turns out there's actually more, but these two are pretty instructive. So let's pretend that we have to choose between always defect as a way of playing against tit for tat, or we have to be always cooperate playing against tit for tat. So what I've written down here is what the total discounted reward is going to be, or the total reward in this case, as a function of gamma. So let's start with what happens if you play always cooperate against tit for tat. Well, you already told me that it such a thing will result in tit for tat always cooperating.
Mm-hmm.
And that means that we're going to play in this box, the cooperate box. And that means on every single round, we're going to get a minus one, which means over an infinite run, we're going to get an average of negative one over one minus gamma.
Mm-hmm. That makes
sense. Okay, you agree with that?
I do.
Just it's minus one repeated over and over again. Now, always defect, as you recall, you told me that that will result, well, for the always defect agent against tit for tat, the first thing that's going to happen is it's going to defect while the tit for tat cooperates, right? So we're going to get zero for playing that strategy on the first round. And zero doesn't sound very good, but look at the alternatives. They're all negative. So zero is pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
So it does this sort of, you know, good thing in the first step. Then after that, tit for tat responds by always defecting in response, right? And that means we're going to be stuck in this box, the defect box. We're going to get minus sixes for the rest of ever.
Yes.
So that means minus six over one minus gamma, but that starts one step from now, so we multiply it by another gamma.
Okay.
All right? So these are two different expressions that represent what our payoff will be for adopting two different strategies. And in fact, if gamma is really high, very close to one, then this is a really good answer, right? Because it sort of grows, it's like minus one over one minus gamma. So for high gamma, we're talking about something that's minus one times a really big number.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas this first one is not so good for high gamma, because what's going to happen is it's going to end up getting minus six on every step. So it's going to do worse overall. But if we're talking about a low gamma, then let's say, you know, zero, for example, a gamma of zero will always defect will get zero plus zero,
right.
But always cooperate will get negative one over one, and zero is better than minus one. So for really small gamma, like if the game's unlikely to last many rounds, you should defect. But if the game is going to last a long time, then you should cooperate.
I believe that.
Cool. All right. So then my question to you is, what's the value of gamma for which these two different strategies to play against tit for tat are equally good?
I think I know the answer.
Whoa, that was fast. Let's give everybody else a chance to think about it.
Okay.